In today's A-level and IB chemistry video, we're going to be looking at calculating percentage yield. So remember, yield is all about how much you actually make. And when you have an equation and you know certain amounts of reactants, then you can certainly predict using mole calculations how much of the product you should make. But remember, because a lot of the time reactions are reversible, products lost, it's not 100% efficient, side reactions take place, all manner of things happen, which means you don't get the amount of product that you would expect. So what we can do, therefore, is work out the amount that we would expect to get, have the amount that they actually got, and pop them into this simple equation in order to work out percentage yield. And the fact that you multiply it by 100 means that it's a percentage yield. So enough talking. As with all chemistry, it's better if we just get going with some examples. So in question one, a company processes 200 kilograms of limestone a day. It collects 98 kilograms of calcium oxide, the useful product. What is the percentage yield? And as always, we need a balanced symbol equation. So limestone is calcium carbonate. And we know that we're producing calcium oxide as the useful product, plus carbon dioxide will be left over. So calcium carbonate is CaCO3, calcium oxide is CaO, carbon dioxide is CO2. Double check that it's balanced. Yes, it is. So using my favorite table format, we're going to put mass, MR, number of moles. And remember, you're using this formula triangle in order to help you work out the number of moles. So in order to solve this question, first of all, we're actually looking for the theoretical mass of calcium oxide. So we're looking for this value. So I'm going to put an X here and pop into the table with the information you've been given. So you know you have 200 kilograms of limestone, so 200 will go in there. Then use your periodic table to work out various MRs. So if you work out the MR of calcium carbonate, so add up calcium plus carbon plus 3 lots of oxygen, you get 100.086. Do the same for calcium oxide, so you're going to do 40.078 plus 15.99 to get a value which is 56.077. Now we can work out the number of moles of calcium carbonate using our formula triangle, so we need to do our mass, which is 200 kilograms, divided by 100.086, that gives you 1.998. And then have a look, check the balanced symbol equation. There are no big numbers, which means you're allowed to copy that number directly across to be the number of moles of calcium oxide. And now, because we have MR, we have the number of moles, we can work out mass. And from our formula triangle, we can see we just need to multiply the mass by the MR. And so X equals 112 kilograms, and that's why it didn't matter that I didn't change my units, because it's comparable. So we now look at our formula. We know we have our actual mass of product producers being 98. The theoretical yield was 112. So what is our percentage yield? We'll just do 98 divided by 112 times by 100, and therefore our percentage yield is 87.5%. In our second example, 100 grams of I2O5 reacts with 33.6 grams of carbon monoxide. Calculate the theoretical yield of carbon dioxide, and given an experimental yield of 0.9 moles of carbon dioxide, calculate the percentage yield. So at the bottom, we can see the equation that we're finally going to get to use to work out the percentage yield. So we're actually going to have to do a whole load of calculations in order to work out the maximum theoretical mass of product. So I'm going to call that X. So as always, let's use a table, and we know that we're looking for the maximum theoretical mass of product, so that's why I'm going to put X here. And the information we've been given is 100 grams of I2O5 and 33.6 grams of carbon monoxide. And this is more complicated than before, because we really need to work out the limiting reagent first of all, because they've given us so much information. We have got to work out the limiting reagent. So check out my other video on limiting reagents if you're not happy with doing this, because this is quite a difficult question. So in order to do this, we need to work out our MRs of I2O5 and CO. So when I pop that into my calculator, using the periodic table to do 2 lots of iodine plus 5 lots of oxygen, let's do the same for carbon monoxide. So we do C, which is 12.01 plus 15.99, which is oxygen, to get 28.009. And periodic tables will be slightly different, so don't get too hung up if your numbers are a little bit different. Now let's work out our number of moles of I205. So using our formula triangle, which states that number of moles is mass divided by MR, we'll do 100 divided by 333.8 to give a number of moles of I205 as being 0.2995. And then here we can work out, based on that amount of I205 reacting, have a look at this mole connection, look at the big numbers in front of the formulae. There's a 5 in front of the carbon monoxide. So take that number in your calculator, 0.2995, and multiply it by 5 to get 1.497. So what this tells you is, according to the amount of I205 that we have, you only need 1.4979 moles of carbon monoxide in order to do this. But how many moles do we actually have? Well, now we can use these two numbers to actually work out the number of moles we have. So just do 33.6 divided by 28.009. You get a value, which is number of moles of CO equals 1.1996. And now compare this number of moles with that number of moles, and you can see that the number of moles provided by the actual amount of carbon monoxide available is far less. It's only 1.1996. So that means that the carbon monoxide is the limiting reagent. And this is going to be really important. So let's make a note that the number of moles of carbon monoxide actually reacting is 1.1996. And now I'm going to just delete some stuff out of my table to make it clearer for you guys. We know that we have 1.1996 moles reacting. So we need to now work out the number of moles of carbon dioxide, because after all, we're after X. So it's a huge number of steps in order to reach that X point. So look at the mole connection. Luckily it's the same, it's 5 to 5, so we can just copy that number across. And then it's the simple expedient of working out the MR of carbon dioxide. So obviously use your periodic table to do that, to get an MR of carbon dioxide of 44.011. And then according to this triangle, mass is given by MR times number of moles. We have the number of moles as being 1.1996. We can multiply it by the MR that we've just calculated to get X as being 52.8 grams. And believe it or not, we now have X down here. In order to use this equation appropriately, look, we have different units. We have a number of moles for the actual mass of product versus an actual mass in grams of the theoretical mass, and it's important that they're in the same unit. So I'm going to work out my actual mass of product produced by just using that 0.9 moles and multiplying by the MR of carbon dioxide. I hope you can see why I'm doing that. It's because I'm using the formula triangle to work out the mass. So I'm just going to do 0.9 times 44.011 to get an actual mass of product produced as being 39.6099. And now we can finally work out the percentage yield by doing 39.6099 divided by 52.8 times by 100. And finally, we have our answer, which is 75.0% to 3 sig fig. That was pretty darn complicated and long, but I'm hoping you can see that it's just using our table and our triangle to work out missing values, which you can then substitute back in. And like I said, please check out my limiting reagent video if you don't like what we did just then, because that was some pretty complicated maths.